Hey everyone, I'm Dr. Neftali Serrano, and this is the Behavioral Health Consultation Podcast, where we talk all things integrated care and PCBH. Today, we're going to have a special podcast on our annual conference. Now, even if you're not going to our annual conference this year in Phoenix, Arizona in October, you may find this interesting just to kind of get a sense of what all the different topics are that encompass integrated care. It is a huge world of interest, of research, of practice development, of system-wide development. And this will give you an insight into what building a career like in integrated care could look like. It could give you insight into the different domains, especially if you're younger in your career, that you could go into. And of course, if you're going to the conference, this is a great cheat sheet to kind of get going early about what you might want to be attending at the conference. All right, so let's jump in. All right, so here we have the conference at a glance. You can download this at integratedcareconference.com. And so it'll give you a quick glance of what the schedule is and what the sessions are, et cetera. As you can see, we've got 3 days. So I'm going to take you through the 3 days here. We've got Thursday on the 19th through Saturday on the 21st. And generally, the days go from early in the morning, as early as you want, at 7 o'clock if you're going to be attending SIG meetings or any of the extended learning opportunities. And then the day ends as late as 7:30 on Thursday, 5:30, 6:30 the other days. So the basic layout of the days is pretty straightforward. It can look a little bit complicated here, which is why I'm doing this video for you all. But basically, day one, if you're going to some of the extended learning opportunities. So these are basically deep dives into topic areas that give you more in-depth training into these areas than just the one-hour sessions that we have throughout the conference, right? So this is like you're really interested in the topic, you love the presenters, and you're going to spend about 3 hours or so with those folks really learning and doing deep dives into these. So those are extended learning opportunities. Those happen on Thursday morning. So for those of you doing that, you're probably going to be showing up to Phoenix on Wednesday sometime. So you're ready bright and early in the morning. And then we get into the rest of the Thursday session with newcomers and then some concurrent sessions and our opening plenary that starts at 3:30. Now a highlight here on the Thursday, there's a poetry and prose session. This was actually a new thing for us last year. We've never done a poetry and prose session. So people can just bring their own poetry and, you know, read their poetry out loud and sit there and hear other people's poetry. It's pretty cool. People really loved it. So come with a couple lines, a couple of verses, whatever it is, healthcare related, not healthcare related, just a really great time to hang out. And speaking of hanging out, that's like the highlight of the conference, right? So it's hanging out, getting to know people. Even if you're new, you don't know anybody at CFHA. I promise you. If you come, you will make new friends. You will find your people, and we make that very easy at the opening reception there at 5 o'clock. That's right after the plenary. So everybody's in the big room together having the opening plenary. Then they come right out to the reception area. We've got some like drinks and hors d'oeuvres, things like that. And people are mixing. We have people hold up signs. Like if you're a social worker, come over here. Or if you're interested in families and health, come over here. If you're interested in our women's leadership group, come over here. You know, there's just a bunch of different things. And then you can start just networking right from the get-go of the conference. So it's really pretty cool. Everybody's open and it's a lot of fun. Really, really good vibe. Really nice vibe, especially to start off the conference that day. Then we get into the Friday sessions. And Friday morning, we have SIG meetings. So those are special interest groups. So if you're interested, for example, in PCBH, if you're looking at this podcast, you probably are. You might want to go to the PCBH special interest group. You might want to go to the COCM special interest group meeting or the families and health meeting or the pediatrics meeting, et cetera, the research and evaluation committee meeting. These are just meetings where these folks get together. They say hi. They've been working together on things all year long, and they get a chance to just talk about what they might want to do for the next year. So Friday morning that happens, there's also SIG meetings on Saturday morning as well. Then we go into some current concurrent sessions. And in a second here, I'm going to take you through to sample those. There's a lot of them, so we're not going to get to all of them here in this video. I don't want to bore you with that, but I'm going to give you a taste, un poquito de sabor, a taste of what these concurrent sessions look like. We've got lunch, and during lunch we have discussion groups, so another time to eat with people, but around topics that are important to you. And you can actually let us know through your registration what discussion groups you might want. And then we have our plenary session. And what's really cool on Friday, that plenary session is going to be one of our more creative sessions. We try to have a session that's more creative, gets you out of the mental cognitive space into more the physical space. So in this case, we have a performance by a group from New Hampshire called Artisan. They do performance around issues related to mental health. And it's, you know, I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be fantastic. And then we end the day there right after that plenary session, come out to the reception area, and we just mingle again around posters, go around and take a look at stuff, talk to people as you go. And then, of course, there's the dinners. You know, if you're an introvert and you just want to go have dinner by yourself, absolutely, you'll be able to do that. But you certainly will not lack for people to have dinner with. So, you know, yeah, if anything, as an introvert, your challenge is going to be like finding time for yourself. I'm an introvert, so I can say that. All right. And then Saturday, same thing, SIG meetings in the morning, some concurrent sessions. That day we have a plenary session earlier in the day. So that plenary session starts at 9:30. And that's followed by some more concurrent sessions. And then lunch, we'll do our award session at that time. And then some more concurrent sessions. And then we wrap up the conference experience. So that's basically the 3 days. It's packed. It's fun. It's energizing. Yeah, I can't wait. I'm getting excited just talking about it with you all. All right, so let's do a quick dive here into what some of the sessions actually look like, so give you a sense. And again, even if you're not going to the conference, like just like pay attention to like how broad this field of integrated care is and the topic areas that people are interested in. All right, so if we look here, all right, so we're looking Thursday. And man, one of the things that you're going to find is there is a breadth, and it sometimes can be difficult to kind of figure out what to go to. So my recommendation is that you definitely choose to go to a good majority of presentations that are in your interest area, right? So if you're interested in pediatrics, or if you're interested in PCBH or COCM specifically, then definitely attend those sessions. But I also suggest that you mix in some more non-traditional sessions for you, kind of stretch you, kind of expand your network of people that you're listening to and aware of. You will be surprised oftentimes by the kind of things that are sparked in your learning, sparked as far as things you can take home with you to maybe act on or to think about, or even sparked for your own career. What are areas that, I didn't think about this before, but this might be an interesting area to develop. And now I know some people who are interested in that I could reach out to, because all these presenters are super open to kind of collaborating. So if you look, for example, we have several COCM sessions during this time. There's actually an external learning. There's several external learning opportunities here this time. So this is not the concurrent session. These are actually the external learning opportunities, those kind of bigger chunks of time that I was talking about before. So you'll see ELO 4, 5, and 7 here. No, sorry, ELO 4, 5, and 8 are COCM focused. So we've got principles for incorporating multiple integrated care models to an organization. So basically that's a session where they're talking about PCBH and COCM in the same organization. I can tell you those presenters are fantastic. Laura Sidari, Monica, Tisha Verna. I mean, I don't think you could possibly get better coaching if you're thinking about COCM and blending it with PCBH or alongside PCBH. That's going to be a fantastic session there. And it's tough because you probably don't want to also miss that advanced skills for collaborative care clinicians. So again, so I would go to ELO 4 if you're really thinking specifically about the interface of PCBH and COCM. I would go to ELO 8 if you're like, you know what, I've got basics down. I'm not really thinking about PCBH. I really just want to hone my skills, get to the advanced level for what we're doing for COCM. Then ELO 8 would be a good one. And then again, fantastic session, collaborative care bootcamp. So this is sort of like, this is if you're a beginner. Like if you're just thinking through COCM from a beginner standpoint, this is the one you want to go to. And Diane and Patty are fantastic people, wealth of information and knowledge. I mean, they're going to be fantastic. Now, if you're a PCBHer, you're going to love and you're going to want to attend the PCBH workshop, do teach lead. And again, you're going to be led by some of the best of the best there with David and Bridget. Again, hard to imagine better people leading you there. So the PCBH workshop would be fantastic. But then, you know, again, and this is the only one where I'm going to go through all of them, because I'm not going to go through all the things, but these are the ELO experiences. If you're interested in just a particular clinical topics, right, you can look at this ELO too. David Clark is always a great presenter on chronic pain and non-pharmacologic options for managing chronic pain. He's got, you know, extensive experience training and all that. So that's going to be great if you're really interested in that. If you're interested in more of just sort of the collaboration for pediatrics, looking at collaborations with schools and interventions and programs that you can interface with between a health center and a school, well, there you go. You've got Maria Rojo and company. I mean, that's a who's who of pediatrics interested folks in CFHA who are leading this session. And they do a great job from a didactic standpoint. Like they know how to teach this stuff. So that's going to be a great session if you're interested in pediatrics. Man, and you know, I should have mentioned this with the PCBH piece, because this supervision session, ELO 7, holy smokes. So Stacy Obide leads our, has a training that we do, a certificate in supervision that we offer. And so she's going to be leading this session with some other who's who people in CFHA. So like, that's just, you know, if you're interested in honing your supervision skills in PCBH, this is going to be a great workshop for you. And then last but not least here, and certainly not least, because this one we're really excited about, if you're a medical professional and you're interested in like just figuring out, hey, how do I lead our clinic in integrated care and developing integrated care? What do we need to know? What are the skills that I need to have? And what impact might this have on our clinic, and how can I sell this to our clinic? Well, you've got several medical provider professionals with lived experience doing this who are also happen to be great coaches for medical providers leading this session, in particular, Jen Thomas and Andy Valeris. They are just fantastic educators, trainers. And again, they just have the lived experience as medical professionals doing this kind of work. They've invited some colleagues to kind of work with them as well. So if you're a medical professional, this is the one for you to attend. Okay, so, all right, I told you I wasn't going to go through all this. I'm super excited just like looking at these. Now I'm just going to go as super quick and just pick out a few from each day just to kind of, again, give you a sense of how broad. But even with those ELOs, you already get a sense of how broad landscape it is that you can get exposed to in integrated care, right? So let's take a look here. So if you look at some of these concurrent sessions, one of the things you'll see here is, you know, some very specific demonstration projects, right? So like AA session AO2 here, facilitators and challenges of implementing a behavioral health model, evidence from a New Jersey demonstration project. All right, so this might be really interesting to you if you're thinking about, like, how do you evaluate a program? How do you collect evidence? And if you're looking at a particular state and you're looking at how to do that in a state, this might be a good exemplar for you. You don't have to be from New Jersey to want to go to this. You can learn about what they did, how they measured it, how they evaluated it, and then adapt it to what you're thinking of there. Now, you'll notice here, there's a long session here that actually cuts across various concurrent sessions, and that's because that's another ELO. We couldn't fit them all into the time. And so this one is, again, if you're interested in managing chronic illness, diabetes, hypertension, et cetera, so this is a primer for you as a BHC. It's led by Randall Wrights, who is an excellent educator, works in family medicine education, so he knows how to teach, and his team is going to do a great job with this, I know. So that's going to be a session that's going to take you across a variety of sessions. All right, let's move down here. And again, if you're interested in pediatrics and this session, you're going to have various options, right? So you have session B01, an implementation and training manual in pediatric integrated primary care. That's going to be a sort of a basic session. But then all the way B08, you're going to have an opportunity to look at what people are doing for pediatric collaborative care. That's pediatric COCM. So you're going to be looking at protocols related to tracking pediatric populations in having care manager-oriented interventions and consulting psychiatry oversight over those, right? So really, really cool stuff. We scroll down here, zero suicide, right? So if you're interested in thinking about how you train your staff potentially or train yourself in terms of a more robust, systematic approach to suicide prevention in your setting, well, there you go. You've got feasibility and impact of zero suicide implementation in a primary care setting in Missouri, right? So you get a good exemplar there from the presenters there. You probably don't want to miss as well. This is what makes it so hard. You've got to choose these things, right? So session C07, you've got Sandy Blount, Jeff Lechter, and Jen Thomas presenting on leadership in primary care behavioral health services. Now, Sandy leads our certificate in PCBH leadership for behavioral health professionals. So he's got a wealth of knowledge related to your leadership development, leadership skill development, right? Yeah, scroll down. There's so much stuff here. All right. Now, if you're looking at something more for your own personal development, there are quite a few sessions throughout the conference on resiliency, on provider resiliency, and reducing burnout. So session DO4, Burnt Out from Combating Burnt Out. That's a great title. Lessons learned from implementing two interventions to address healthcare worker burnout in the VA system. So again, really cool way to kind of think about learning from what they did in their system, how it might apply for your system. Session DO1 is a really interesting one. Again, thinking about the breadth of what we address here. So here, Kathy Hudgens and colleagues here, and again, really great presenter list here, are going to review LMFT and LPC education training and competencies, and you know, linking that at how prepared is this workforce for the expansion occurring in 2024. What they're referring to is just that those folks will now be able to bill incident to under Medicare, right? And so it'll be a little bit policy oriented, a little bit of training and competency oriented there. So if you're in the training education world, or just thinking about how you incorporate LMFTs and LPCs onto your team now that they can bill, there's a session for you. Yeah, boy, there's so much here. All right, I'm going to just wrap up with a couple of quick ones, right? So, yeah, if you're in the realm of education, Kara Hill here, right in the middle, EO6, launching a new BHC workforce development course. Kara Hill developed a course in Texas for this. This will be great for you if you're an educator thinking through that. If you're thinking about a specific population, particularly like Latinx population, session FO3, taking primary care to a higher level, a health center's journey to serving a Mexican-American community. And we've got a slew of topics on DEI and certain clinical population foci throughout the conference. So you're going to be able to find a good chunk of that kind of thing for you here at the conference. All right. This is another example of some DEI stuff. Session G11, Allison Allman Dixon, longtime CFHA-er, Gender Euphoria, Building Resilience in Rural and Underserved LGBTQ plus Youth, right? So again, very clinically minded kind of topic, right? And we're just wrapping up a day here. There's even just some really interesting, like, we like to think outside the box here. Session, HO7, using photography to elicit internal medicine physicians' experiences with burnout and wellness. So, yeah, another creative topic. You know, I'm interested to see what David and Maxine have to teach us. If you're interested in families in particular in family-based interventions, HO2, minding the patient and family, developing an integrated family-centered concussion clinic in primary care, right? So it's really looking at a very specific topic and saying, how do we do this in a way that really takes the family context in mind? And then last day of the conference, you're going to want to stay through the whole thing because there's really some great sessions here. You've got a wellness curriculum for family medicine residents. You've got a session on registered dietitians collaborating with BHCs and the PCBH model. Let's see, you've got a session on health equity and policy related to mental health and programming in integrated mental health settings. You've got again, a very specific topic, brief CBT for insomnia. We've got a topic there, session KO7. Jen Furnerberg is a great presenter there. We're happy to have her again. And the integrated pediatric well-child visit, a framework for building equity and family resilience through preventative and integrated care. Again, a great pediatrics topic. And in our last session of the day, heck, if you want to think about yoga, yeah, Rosemary Hale is going to be talking to you about yoga. There's an ELO, actually, I forgot to mention, there's an ELO above on yoga and its application to health and wellness. So yoga-based interventions and applying psychological flexibility skills to treating chronic pain. So what a great way. That'd be a great way to end a conference right there with a Rosemary session there. Last but not least, we've got some family medicine residency training sessions. We've got some trauma sessions. We've got some burnout sessions. And we've got some sessions on diabetes management. Gosh. All right. Well, if you haven't gotten the gist of it, you've got this document to look over. Take a look at it. Again, even if you're not coming to the conference, take a look at it. This is a great way to think about your career. It's a great way to think about what skills there are that you might want to develop. Great way to think about who the people are who are doing it. Our conference is a big networking conference. And if anything, it might get you excited for coming in future years if you're not able to come this year. All right. So it's going to be a great time. We hope to see you there. Again, integratedcareconference.com is where you find this document and all the information related to the conference. We do hope to see you there. If you are there and you're a podcast viewer here of the Behavioral Health Consultant Podcast, come up and say hi. I'll be milling around. Tell me I told you to come up and say hi, and that's why you're saying hi. All right. For the Behavioral Health Consultation Podcast, and for the Collaborative Family Healthcare Association that is the sponsor of this podcast, I'm Dr. Fali Serrano. Until next time.